Now with everything we know in chemistry, sometimes we learn rules and sometimes those rules have exceptions. So now we're going to talk about the exceptions to the rules we just learned. So there are two major exceptions that we have. So let's look at this first compound, H2CO4. We say that this compound is called oxalic acid. Oxalic acid. We're going to say here, when we do the math, it's 4 minus 2, so we have 2 oxygens left. We've met the minimum requirement. We need at least 2 oxygens left. But this one is still weak. And we're going to say it's still weak because carbon is not a very electronegative element. So the fact that carbon is not very electronegative causes this to be a weak acid. So just remember, oxalic acid is an exception to the rule we just learned. Now the second structure, when we do the math, we get 4 minus 1 gives us 3 oxygens left. So it would look like this passes the test too, but it doesn't. We're going to say it doesn't pass the test because it has a negative charge. We're going to say when you have a negative charge, that makes you a base. But it also has hydrogen, and that makes it an acid. So we're going to say this compound can behave as an acid or a base. We're going to learn that this is called being an amphoteric species. Amphoteric species can act as acids in one case or base in another. So we'd say normally, because we have 3 oxygens left, it's strong. But the fact that we have this negative charge makes it kind of like a base at the same time. This decreases the acidity, and because of that, this is a weak acid. And the thing is, it can act as an acid or a base. It's amphoteric. We'll learn more about amphoteric species later on. But just realize, it passes the numbers test. It has 3 oxygens left, but the negative charge actually makes it a weak acid. Now that you guys have seen this, I want you guys to attempt to do the practice question left on the bottom of the page. Rank the following oxyacids in terms of increasing acidity. So remember, what do we look at? First, we look at the number of oxygens. If they're tied, then we look at electronegativity. Use those two factors to determine the correct order. Good luck, guys.